Escape Room 2 Tournament of Champions has just came out this past weekend. Find out my review next. What's up, guys? This is Reviews with Ryan. Today I'm going to be reviewing a movie called Escape Room 2 Tournament of Champions. This is directed by Adam Robidel and stars Taylor Russell and Logan Miller. So before I get into Escape Room 2, I just want to say there's a few little spoilers I'm going to share with the first film. So if you have not watched the first film, now's your warning to turn off this review. So in the first film, in Escape Room, there were only two survivors. And with these two survivors, they've come back in the second film. And now we have six characters and they are in new escape rooms and they're trying to figure out what common things they share to get to this point, and as the title suggests, Tournament of Champions, so they all have been in this spot before. I will list off some of the negatives I didn't like about the film and some of the positives. With the negatives of this film, I felt that they didn't really develop the characters as much. I felt like in the first film, they kind of have different situations as to why these characters were here, and they have a little bit of backstory for some of those characters. With this film, there really isn't any backstory to these characters. A lot of them are kind of cliche type characters that are thrown into the film, and I felt like that could have been done a little bit better. Also, with the rooms aren't as a strong point as in the first film. However, there's a lot more strategic type of aspects that are in this second film that is different from the first film. And one good thing I like about this film is not all horror needs to be gore and blood and all that type of stuff. This kind of film does not have that kind of aspect going for it, and it's the same for the first film as well. So if you didn't like the first film, then you're not going to get much of a change in the second film as well. But what holds this film together is the fact that Ben and Zoe from the first film are back, so they already kind of have that relationship and bond going for it. Also, there's more of a budget in this film, so there is a lot more things they can do in this film. And with that, there is a lot of CGI involved in this film, but it's done better and it definitely helps the film a little bit more than the first film. With a lower budget that they had, even though they made a ton of money, it was a lower budget and they were limited on what they could do in the first film. So with the more of a budget that they had, it definitely helped the film develop a little bit more. Something else noteworthy about this film, it's not really a negative or a positive, it was just kind of weird, but in the beginning of the film, they show a recap of what happened in the first film, almost like if you're watching a TV show and you haven't watched the season or the last episode. They show you everything that pretty much happened in a little 5-minute clip. And yeah, that was kind of an interesting decision that they did that. I didn't really hate it. It was just something interesting that they threw in there. I think this is a pretty fun movie. I really liked the first one. I thought it was pretty solid, and I feel the same about this film too. It was entertaining for me. I definitely was intrigued by the story. I do think, like I said, there are some things they can improve on to make it a better film. And it'd be interesting to see if they do a third film, just based on how everything that was thrown together in this film. The thing I also like about these films is they're pretty intense. There's definitely some intense scenes that was filmed in this, and that definitely makes it more intriguing for the viewer to watch. Even the twists and turns with this film, some of the stuff that goes on and what they show and what happened in this film, I definitely didn't expect some of the things to happen that they did. I was invested in the two main characters from the first film, so I definitely have interest in their characters and where they're going with this journey of this film. So I definitely was invested in this film. And while I see that some people compare this film to Saw a lot, this is its own thing. It may have a slight comparison to Saw, but it really is nothing like Saw, and it's not the gore fest like Saw is at all. And I think that's why I like it, just because it's just a little bit more tamed and it's a little bit different, and it's not like the same kind of horror movie for me. And yes, it's tamed down, like I said, but I do enjoy it, and I think that you should check it out if you get a chance. I'm going to give this film a 3.5 out of 5, just like the first film. I do think there should be some improvements going if there is a third film to see the light of the day. But if you guys do get a chance, check it out at the theater. And I will see you guys in my next review. Like, comment, subscribe, and let me know what you guys think of this film. Thank you guys for watching.